What's up, guys? EpicConspiracy here. Today I'm going to dive back into my WWE home video DVD collection and do a little review, which we're going to get into the red and yellow, the Hulk Hogan Ultimate Anthology Collection from WWE Home Videos. So sit back and relax and enjoy the show. All right, here we go, the Hulk Hogan Anthology. I mean, as you can see, the front cover looks really good, has Hogan posing there. And let's flip it open. And here's disc one. It's got all the matches here. It's got awesome drawings and pictures. The actual disc has some cool print on it. Disc two, same way. Awesome print on the disc. Lists all the matches. Got some more pictures. And here's disc three, right here. And all the matches again, pictures. And here's the disc. Pretty cool. And here's the back of the box. I mean, this one here has some great artwork and pictures on it. I really thought they did a good job on that. Hey guys, being a big Hulkamaniac, Hogan's my favorite ever since I could remember. He was the first wrestler I rooted for. Still root for him today. And there's been a few DVD sets of him. And the first one we're going to tackle here is the Ultimate Anthology set. Like the back of it says, the three-disc set covers the amazing career of the greatest superstar in the history of sports entertainment, Hulk Hogan. He has mesmerized fans from the birth of Hulkamania in the mid-80s and continues to wow fans today. So, I mean, this is an excellent set. It's a three-disc set, as you saw. So, let's get into seeing what matches are on here. Alright, on disc one, there's Hogan versus Andre the Giant in 1980. See, this match was cool because this was before Andre was all gimped, because he was running around doing like jump kicks and stuff. Hogan actually loses the match. Hogan actually picks Andre up and slams him in the match. I mean, real easy, like much easier than he did in WrestleMania 3, because Andre was a lot more leaner. He was more muscular and less fat then. But in the match, Hogan, like, Andre hits Hogan, so Hogan's back is hurt. So Hogan slams him one time, and then he tries to slam him again, and Andre falls on him. And Andre wins by a three count. But it wasn't a clean win because it was a fast three count because the ref was in with Andre and his team or whatever. The second match is the AWA title match, Hogan versus Nick Bockwinkel of 83. Then we have, of course, the WWE Championship match when Hogan fights the Iron Sheik. Then we have another WWE Championship match in 84 where Hogan fights Big John Studd. And it has another WWE title match, Hogan versus Rowdy Piper, war to settle the score. Then we got, of course, Hogan, Mr. T, against Piper and Orndorff in WrestleMania 1. Then we have a WWE Championship match in the steel cage of WrestleMania 2, Hogan versus King Kong Bundy. Next is a WWE title match, Hogan versus Paul Orndorff. And then the final match of the disc is WrestleMania 3, Hogan versus Andre the Giant. Some extras on the disc. Hogan talks about his early days in wrestling, and Iron Sheik talks about his match versus Hulk Hogan. All right, now let's go to disc number two. We have the WWE title match, Hogan versus the Macho Man Randy Savage, WrestleMania 5. Then we have the WrestleMania 6 match, Hogan versus the Ultimate Warrior, title versus title. And then after that, we have the Hogan versus Slaughter WrestleMania 7 championship match. The only thing I was disappointed in that, they didn't really give a ton of the backstory of the Hogan-Slaughter thing, because that was just an amazing story of everything Slaughter had to do. They just talked about it for a couple minutes. They didn't go too in-depth, so I was a little disappointed in that. Then after that, we have the WCW championship match, Bash at the Beach, Hogan versus Flair. July 17, 94, was Hogan's first match in WCW, and he wins the title. Then we go to the NWO, the formation of the NWO, Bash at the Beach. They talk a lot about the NWO in this disc. The next is Hollywood Hogan versus the Giant at Hog Wild. And then the last match on the disc is Hulk Hogan versus Sting at Starrcade in 97, where Sting comes back after being away for a year. Alright, then we're at disc three. A match probably maybe no one's ever seen before. It's Hulk Hogan versus Curt Hennig. November 14th, 01 in the XWF. It was Jimmy Hart's wrestling organization. Hogan was down there just doing a photo shoot, and he had his gear and stuff, and Curt Hennig was, I guess, making fun of him backstage, like, "Oh man, you can't wrestle." So he got Hogan to go in and wrestle the match. So you could tell Hogan was a little out of shape then, but it was still an awesome match, a match right from the 80s. You know, Kurt hitting perfect plexum, Hogan kicks out, he gets all hawked up, drops the leg, and wins the match. But right after it, Mean Gene was there, and he did an interview with Hogan, just cut a promo, and Hogan's like, I might stay here and go after the title in the XWF. I mean, Hogan was just awesome on the mic, right on the spot. I mean, he delivered an awesome, you know, mic speech. The next match was probably maybe Hogan's greatest match of his career. It's the Hogan Rock match of WrestleMania 18 in 02. Then after that, we have the Hogan versus Triple H title match, where Hogan wins the title from Triple H. And then we have it where Hogan and Edge versus Chuck and Billy, when Hogan wins the tag team title for the first time in his career. Then we have the street fight Hogan versus McMahon match. That match was fucking unbelievable in 2003. I mean, McMahon kind of whoops Hogan's ass the whole time, but Hogan, of course, ends up winning. Then we have the WWE Hall of Fame induction ceremony, where Hogan gets inducted to the Hall of Fame and gives a great speech. I mean, that was a great moment in Hogan's career. And then the last match on the DVD is Hulk Hogan versus Shawn Michaels at SummerSlam, legend versus icon match, which I thought was a great match. Shawn Michaels got a lot of shit for like overdoing a lot of things on the match, but I thought he was great. I thought Hogan was great. It was a great match. This is a great DVD set. It looks great, has tons of great matches. So if you're a fan of retro wrestling and you're a Hogan fan, this is a must own. I give it a solid 9 out of 10. Of course, anything with Hogan in it, I'm going to give it a high score. So check it out. And also, if you like my wrestling videos here, if you want to follow somebody that, I mean, his whole channel is pretty much dedicated to wrestling. He's probably one of my favorite wrestling people on YouTube. It's go to Canadian Warrior 1995. That's Canadian Warrior 1995. And subscribe to him, because he does lots of wrestling. He has breaking news, and he is, in my opinion, one of the top guys to follow on YouTube if you want to watch and listen to someone talk about wrestling, old and new. So follow him, Canadian Warrior 1995. But until next time, it's Epic Conspiracy signing out.